We're going to talk a little bit about long division in this video. Kind of a unique question. It says factor this polynomial completely using long division if x minus 3 is a factor. Well, how do we know if something is a factor? How do we know that 6 is a factor of 42? That we can divide 42 by 6 evenly with a remainder of nothing? That is what we're going to check here first. Is this a factor? Well, we're going to take our polynomial, divide it by x minus 3 first. That's our first step. If we get a remainder of 0, it is a factor, and we can factor what's left over our depressed polynomial. Whew, nose is itching today. Don't know why. Long division, set it up like long division, good old long division that you saw back in sixth grade or whatever it was. And we look at this first term. What times x gives us 6x cubed? 6x squared. And I'm going to write 6x squared right here because I'm going to put it in line over my x squareds. 6x squared times x gives me 6x cubed. That's the goal, to get it to look exactly the same. 6x squared times negative 3 is a negative 18x squared. Just like in long division in sixth grade, we now subtract. Another way to subtract is to add the opposite. These, of course, cancel out. Negative 25x squared plus 18x squared is a negative 7x squared. Same idea. What times x gives me negative 7x squared? Of course, negative 7x. Again, put it in line over the other term that has an x. Negative 7x times x is a negative 7x squared. Negative 7x times negative 3 is a positive 21x. My apologies, I really should bring down this positive 18x earlier, or we can just do it now. That didn't change anything in the problem. And so we carry on. We're going to subtract what we've now written down. Just like before, we can add the opposite. Negative 7 plus 7, as hoped, cancels out. 18x plus a negative 21x gives me a negative 3x. Bring that down. Usually it makes sense to do it right here. What times x gives me negative 3x? Negative 3. Negative 3 times x is a negative 3x. Negative 3 times negative 3 is a positive 9. If these things are identical, when we subtract them, anything minus itself becomes 0. So we do have that remainder of 0. When we get that remainder of 0, and we have divided this, is what we call the depressed polynomial. This is left over. This is what we call the depressed polynomial. And it says factor this completely. So we want to finish factoring this. We want to factor what's left over. I have this 6x squared minus 7x minus 3 is left over. We now know that x minus 3 was a factor of that original, so we know that this times x minus 3 gives us that original polynomial. Hope you followed that. If you did, you can always rewind and rewatch. This times this gives us our original, so by saying and showing that this gave me a remainder of 0, this times the depressed polynomial gives me my original. And so I've already factored a little bit. I've factored through division. It's just like saying, okay, I want to factor 40. I know it's 8 times 5. There's our 5. There's our 8. I can still factor that 8 to a 4 times 2 and maybe further. Of course, further in this case, it's 2 times 2. But we want to factor, just like this 8, we can factor it further. We want to do that right here and factor this 6x squared minus 7x minus 3. Well, we do that. 6 times negative 3 gives me a negative 18. And I'm thinking to myself, what are two numbers that multiply to get negative 18 add to get negative 7? My method, I put a 6x in front of both. I look at that negative 18. I know that it is a negative 9 and a positive 2 that multiply to get that add to get a negative 7. I'm going to divide these by as much as possible. I can divide this one by 3, this one by 2, undoing that multiplication by 6 from earlier. And so I'm left with 2x minus 3 times 3x plus 1. I've broke this down, and then this one stays exactly the same because we cannot break that down anymore. This is the complete factorization of our original equation.